first of all, who you hire is a big deal. So you can, if you hire someone, it's super, super talented, but you know they are the meanest person in the world, you really have to be conscious about that decision. And there, sometimes you do have to make that decision. Oh, okay, the talent comes with a little bit of, a little bitterness there, and you go, okay, I'm going to have to handle that because I will not let that infect the set, because I generally I think the crews that work on my movies would generally say it's the best experience they've had in movie making, simply because it's supportive and loved and focused, and everyone is behind the same goal. So like from the first outset, I'll sit everybody down, all the keys. I'm about to do this for my next movie. Bring everybody to Philadelphia, sit them all down, and tell them the vision of the movie and why I'm doing it, where it's coming from, and what this means to me, you know, philosophically, emotionally, artistically, why I think this can be a particularly powerful, original take on a movie. You basically have to make them drink the Kool-Aid, and you got to see it in their eyes, every single one of them, the costumer, the cinematographer, every single one, the construction head, every one of them, and say, and this is where we're going. And let them ask their questions, and let them bring their doubts to the table right away. And what happens is, they end up, because they're so talented, all these people, they end up giving you the benefit of all their support and all, and everyone is moving in the same direction. There isn't any of that, fractiousness that I've heard can come on sets and all. And I've worked with amazing actors, all varied backgrounds, all varied reputations, and they've always been kind of angelic on the set. Partly because, you know, we respect what we're doing. There will be no time where, like, you know, I'm on the phone with the realtor while I'm like, yeah, and action. Okay. No, we don't want to do that. You know, it's not like that. It would never be like that. Preparation is the single thing that would define how I make movies. I don't want to think about making movies on the computer after the fact. I don't want to gather ingredients and figure out what we're making later. This isn't a shopping trip. This is, you have a specific vision. If a scene is with me and another person, whose scene is it? How do we shoot that so that we can help that person's character? How do we do that? Commit, commit to everything. As you know, you're not going to get everything right, but you've committed, and you certainly will hear who I am. And that's what art is about, really, to kind of hear someone say, this is what I feel about a flower. This is what I feel about love. This is what I feel, you can hear their voice, and then you go, God, I feel the same way. I feel connected to this human being, the vulnerabilities, their flaws, everything about it. The humanity comes from me being able to go over and over with the best people in the world, the movie, very, very specifically, keep talking about it and saying, something's wrong, I don't know why. When you place the window here, can we, before you build that wall, what are you trying to say with that window? You know, literally have those kind of conversations about every single detail. When we get to the set, it's almost the scariest moment, because the movie I have in my head is perfect, and there's no way to get that movie out. You're basically, you try to shoot it, and oh, the window is actually facing a tree that's not very good for the framing, so you actually have to move to the right, which now shows you the coat rack, and I didn't really want to do that, and, all the flaws of being in reality. It sometimes becomes, that you have to take a deep breath and go, it's not going to be as perfect as in your head.